Hi, Dr. Dave here to show you the most important changes I made to my game over the years that resulted in the most improvement. These things might help you too. I used to align my head with the cue close to my dominant eye, since that is what came naturally. But what comes naturally isn't always the best. I often miss shots because of this, especially long shots. I noticed the problem one day when I was doing a stop shot drill and I was sending the cue ball to the right on every shot, even though they all looked straight. Once I found my true personal vision center, I immediately started missing fewer shots, and not just straight shots, all shots. See the link in the video description for videos, articles, and other information for how to find your personal vision center head position. Many people think and recommend that the cue should always be centered between the eyes or be directly under or close to your dominant eye, but your personal vision center position can be very unique and totally unrelated to which eye might be dominant or not. Nothing but net. I used to stand like old pool books and videos told me to stand, using a closed stance with the back leg locked, but it caused me lots of neck, back, and hamstring discomfort, especially when I played often or in long sessions. Once I found my personal best stance, using the stance dance procedure demonstrated at the link in the video description, I no longer had discomfort, and it became much easier to position my vision center accurately and consistently. This definitely made my play better and more enjoyable. Nothing but net. I used to get down in my stance too quickly without aiming the shot carefully while standing. When I aimed while down in the shot, I often missed shots, especially long back cuts, because the angles always looked wrong when down in my stance. It is much more effective to aim and align while standing, where you can more clearly see the shot, the line to the pocket, the ghost ball position, the shot angle, and the required line of aim. I learned to aim while standing like most top players do. I also learned to trust and maintain the required shot picture as I dropped straight down into my stance. Aiming while standing might be the one thing that has helped my game the most.
Well, I got luck.
In my early days, I had a terrible eye pattern, not focusing very well on things that are important. I used to move my eyes back and forth quickly while moving the cue during my pre-shot routine. I also didn't lock my focus on the object ball target before my final stroke. Because I wasn't checking the tip position and cue alignment carefully, and because I wasn't developing intense focus on my target, I was not very effective. Once I learned to quiet my eyes and actually focus on the things that are important, I immediately got better. Now I keep my cue still at address, carefully checking tip position and making sure my cue is aligned with the line of aim I established with my aim while standing shot picture. I also now lock my focus on the object ball target as I drop down into my stance to help guide me straight down while maintaining the shot picture. I also lock my eyes on the object ball target before my final stroke to have still and intense focus. All these things resulted in better accuracy and consistency. In my early pool days, I was a rail banger, where I would move my shoulder and drop my elbow during shots. This made draw shots very difficult and inconsistent, because if the elbow drops before the hit, the tip comes up, resulting in much less or no backspin. Despite my low tip at address, I actually hit the cue ball above center, resulting in a follow shot. I also sometimes miscued on follow shots, with the tip rising above the ball.
Oh!
Once I learned to keep my shoulder and elbow more still with a pendulum stroke, my accuracy and consistency improved on every shot, especially stun, draw, and follow shots.
Well, I got luck in the
In the past, I used to worry about scratching, or I did scratch. I couldn't hit carom or kiss shots effectively. And I had poor position play skills. Now I use the 90 and 30 degree rules and the 3 times the angle system to accurately predict and create the cue ball motion I want over a wide range of shots. For more information, see the cue ball control link in the video description. That's what it takes to be a good player. You need to be able to pocket a ball, but you also need to be able to control the cue ball well enough to be able to keep pocketing balls. For example, here the scratch is natural, but I know I can easily avoid it by not letting the cue ball have full topspin roll into the 11. And here, I can accurately draw to carom into the 5. And with good visualization and cue ball control skills, it is much easier to get the shape you need to win the game. An easy, straight, winning look at the 8 like this is my favorite shot in pool.
Well, I got luck in the
I used to try to control shot speed using the same full stroke using different stroke speeds. Sometimes it would work, but other times, like with this failed safety attempt, where I'm trying to hide my opponent behind the 13 with no look at the 1, my finesse and consistency were terrible. A much better approach is to pull back less for slower speed shots, still accelerating smoothly the same way on every shot. The changing stroke length automatically creates the desired speeds. It's like putting or chipping in golf, where you control the ball travel distance by the amount you pull back the club head. If you want to learn more about any topic in this video, check out the video and resource page links in the video description. They cover everything in great detail with lots of good examples.
I hope you enjoyed the video, and I hope that the things that helped me so much over the years help you too. Good luck with your game from Dr. Dave.
Thank you.